Yep. Are we going to try this?
First wash of the 61 GE combo.
First wash ever.
Well, since I've had it.
A little scan of the panel.
So far, okay. It's still filling. Yeah, exactly.
Do you know where the water level is supposed to be on this, John?
Below the window.
Below the window?
Yeah.
So if you were to open it?
Oh, you can always open these at any time.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, the water level is supposed to be something like 3 to 4.5 inches in the cylinder.
Oh, okay. All right.
Sounds pretty good. This is the first time it's been run with water?
Yes.
It's maiden wash.
Yeah.
So cool.
Not leaking.
That's good.
Still not viable.
Oh, it's got the escaping timer.
Yeah.
Nice.
I noticed that online.
Oh, yeah. All the GE combos.
I've got a water leak, though. You look down that way.
Oh, back there, yeah.
That's really nice wash that.
Yeah, it is.
These clean great. Six baffles in the tub. Incredible.
I got the C model under counter one at home.
Oh, cool.
C model.
Yeah, this was the
that's like a 66. Isn't it?
Yeah, it's the last one of the last model years.
Far from the last. They made it through 72.
Oh, did they?
Yep. The under counter.
According to what I saw in the repair manual, it was the last series they started making.
Yeah, they changed it a little bit, but mechanically it is the last. I have a C model in my kitchen also.
Really?
It was a copper
one they were working on?
In black.
Oh, yeah, it had a small leak.
I've had that for about 25 years.
Still dripping a little bit.
The door's leaking a little bit.
Better call warranty service. Do you use yours much?
Yeah. Actually, when I first hooked it up, the water valve was shut off. It just kept right.
Oh, yeah.
Right. So, unfortunately, I took the valve apart. Now it leaks a little bit. I need to get it sealed again properly.
You can rebuild that. You just have to buy this.
The other problem I've got is the dispenser between the bleach and the
power
softener. That wall has deteriorated.
Oh,
the first wash since I got it.
I probably have some of those too.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I have boxes of parts for that. Because when we first went in business, we took care of an apartment complex at 500, 1966
through 7. It's nice that GE equipped these with ashtrays.
What?
With ashtrays.
Not an ashtray.
That way you can be smoking while you do your laundry.
That's right. And your clothing will smell of ashes because actually it's in the rinse. It was one of the only fabric softener dispensers that never clogged at this period because it flushes 30 gallons of water.
Oh, yeah, through when it's dry.
Because it flushes the condenser water through that dispenser.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, so I mean, it never clogged. This little tray would get real gummy, but it comes out easily for cleaning.
Wow.
And these got real gummy. In fact, I clean mine every time I use it because it gets gummy. But everything that goes beyond there is right in there and is totally flushed away.
Is a bleach dispenser a reservoir?
No, this just goes right in. It goes down. It dilutes it. It's a diluter, much like, you know, the Nord and the Whirlpool.
So one more time, if you start to do it with a warm wash.
Warm wash, it's a warm all the way through.
Okay.
If you do hot, it's hot wash, cold rinse, warm rinse, hot rinse.
Really?
And using the same amount of hot water in either set. But you're better off using the hot wash because it heats up and goes through the dry phase.
That's true. So this is a condenser dryer.
Yeah.
It actually uses cold water when it's drying to between 30 gallons an hour.
There are some things that are sensitive to heat that you probably would
not use.
Really? This uses it's a closed chamber, and it has 4,000 watts of electric heat up across the top.
Okay.
It runs cold water down the inside of the outer tub down the hole, sort of from about, maybe 2 o'clock down some. So basically, a steamy mixture just condensed and carried down the drain. So a one-hour dry cycle uses 30 gallons of cold water. And there's no lint, there's no venting, there's no heat in your house.
Wow.
But it uses 30 gallons.
That's a lot of water.
That's a lot of water.
Yeah.
But for the wash,
probably not allowed to have this.
But then again, for the wash and all the rinses, how many gallons do you guess it uses?
Well, it's a little more economical than a top loader of its time.
Right.
It's moving, but the contacts actually open and close pretty quickly.
Why not?
In fact, they fall off a cam so fast. But
the GE was the only one I think that had a continuously moving cycle dial.
On the older, the larger
ones didn't make as much of a noise.
There is.
Wow. Remember that 518? I found a brand new OEM valve.
It might not even have a pilot light on it.
There you go, 200 RPM.
Yeah, the 225 RPM.
225?
Yeah, you can still raise water.
Concrete sole, the previous generation, the same style, bigger style.